Yeah, it's funny you should say that, actually, because I have, like, 10 monkeys constantly doing that for me at all times.
Oh, really?
Yeah, I mean, and, you know, it's not something I like to share.
Sounds kind of cruel. Yeah. You should probably get, you know, go see someone about that.
Well, I've been.
Oh, hey there.
Oh, hi.
Didn't see you there.
Yeah.
Hiya.
Don't worry about any of that.
You don't need to know anything.
We're on Zelda.
Zelda.
Wait, I forgot. I've been here.
Episode 17 of Zelda. Is it?
Oh, it is. Well done. Hang on. Wait, did we have
seven?
Did we have more on the last? No, because we were exactly here at the end of the last episode. Yeah,
one
17.
And a seven together in unison. That's what you get. When you come over here, come on the Carlos Crumpets channel. See a one and a seven together in the same room. No one knows how it happened.
What are your favourite numbers, Refson?
8 and 6.
That's pretty good. Mine are 11 and 58.
Actually, no, I just answered that, like, as a knee jerk. My actual, my genuine favourite number is actually 7.
Is that guy
7.
Just staying there? He's just, oh, okay.
It's got to be 7, because the thing is with 7, you never know what you're getting.
I don't know about that.
Well,
genuinely
yeah.
Don't
listen,
know about
on the
that.
Surface, that does not sound like an intelligent thing to say, but bear with me, right? With a 7, turn it upside down, L. You know? What other number that exists in the world can do that? Apart from 5,000 and whatever it is to make boobs, if you flip it over.
Or boobies.
Oh, boobies.
If you had a 1-3-S. I mean, a 1-3-5. Oh no, I got it before I could catch it in a bottle. Never mind. It's all right. You were just like, I've got loads to talk about. Come on, get
all right.
It out.
Okay, yeah, sorry.
Give me some fucking
right.
Dutch information.
So basically, at my work, I had to do two things in the last. In the last time I've seen you, I've done two things that are just so not me. I just have to share it. It's okay. Just so first thing, corporate induction. This is a full day. Wait, okay, you don't have to do any work and you sit there and you can go home at 4 o'clock, which is chill, obviously.
Yeah, that's pretty nice.
But you know, it's a corporate induction. Different people from different parts of the business come and tell you about how the business works, and there's some hands on activities that are supposed to you know, get to know people and
that
all that.
Genuinely distressing.
Yeah, you know, but at the same time, they pay me money and they were paying me money to be there. So I was
there. Yeah, of course, that makes everything okay, obviously.
Yeah. Anyway. This is at 9:30 in the morning.
Sorry, that episode, that you can't tell that. No, it had bad stuff
okay,
in it.
Okay, I wasn't allowed to. I've been censored. I've been officially censored.
Yep.
So, right, I will tell it without the censored bit then.
Yeah, they see so, you can do it. You were like,
yeah, I know,
funny.
But,
it's
know,
intrinsic.
Well, it is intrinsic. We're going to go now because of laws. Fucking not... laws that apply to 30 people. It's bollocks. Anyway, I'm here. I'm ready. Right.
See, this is funnier
already. Right, basically. So, the first bit of it was an icebreaker exercise.
Oh, good.
Which I'd really like, if you could, just get some kind of haunting music for this bit, okay? So, imagine me, right, 9:30 in the morning, pretty tired, not really, don't want to be around people. If any of you have listened to this, you know I hate people, don't like them, don't care for them, not into them. So, I sit in this room with 10 others, most of which are like, you know, 30, 40, you know, they have kids or really like football teams that don't matter. And our first exercise is a icebreaker exercise where you have to draw a giant shield on paper, real paper, and then split the shield into four sections. And in each four sections, you had the following. In the first section, you'd say stuff about yourself, what you like doing, and, you know, your hobbies outside of work, blah, blah, blah. Second is, like, where you're from. Third is, I think it was like, what your previous experience and roles, and then five, your role at the company. So the last three, not a problem. It's not going to be, is it? I do code, and that weird IT guy never leaves the house. Everyone can see that. That's fine. No one gives a shit. But the first one, obviously, I'm a man with many hobbies, got many talents. Thankfully, I'm very lucky.
Fuck.
But in having those talents and hobbies, I actually kind of found myself at a disadvantage in this situation because I wear all the shit that I like to do in my Let's Plays, my comedy, my music, my photography, my all blah, 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 blah.
Yeah.
And it sparked just debate when I finally got to Magic the Gathering. Because obviously I'm going to say, well, I really like Magic the Gathering because I really play it all the time.
Of course,
I love it.
Yeah, why the fuck shouldn't you?
And, oh, God. If anyone's ever had an experience in trying to explain what Magic the Gathering is to four people over 30 and one, no offense to her, genuinely lovely bimbo who had no idea what she was on about, it was, oh God, it was horrible. It was like, oh right, so you're a producer, oh cool, oh you make albums, that's cool, oh you take photos, that's really cool, what's Magic the Gathering? Is it a bit like Pokemon? Well, yeah, it is. And then, but then the thing is that wasn't enough for them. That in itself, it's like,
why
really
is that not enough?
I know, because it's like, all you have to really explain with Magic is, it's like really fucking
intense. It's really
Pokemon.
Yeah.
It's just Pokemon cards.
It's more difficult, I think, isn't it?
Yeah, it's more difficult. It's more intense. It's more complicated.
Whoa, can you just...
Whoa.
Am I moving?
That's crazy.
I'm moving.
Are you moving? No, you're not.
I'm moving.
That's crazy. Anyway. So... It all comes to a head, right? So we're having a coffee break and we're allowed to go out. My desk's just outside the place we're doing it, so I'm going to do a bit of work. Came back and this girl was like, so what is Magic the Gathering? And I was like, oh, you know, it's explaining, you know, it's like Pokemon, but well, one sense. She was like, I don't know what Pokemon is. And I was like, oh my God, please don't do this.
Yeah.
So then she wanted a full explanation on the whole game. She actually didn't ever finish asking. It was like, I was like, right, okay, so you got creatures and each one has a power and toughness and they fight each other. She was like, well, what? And I was like, you know, well, they don't actually fight. They're not real.
Yeah.
But they fight. Oh, God. It was so, so awkward. It was literally one of the most awkward things.
Maybe she wanted to play.
In my whole life. Like, because you know when people are asking you something and the reason they're asking, it's not just to make polite conversation, however much they say. It's to take the piss out of what you're doing.
It's because they don't know. Yeah, oh,
they don't
I
understand
see.
It. They don't understand it. And they just want it. They want you to explain to, like, confirm what they already think.
So she was... Oh, I died.
Oh, he died, shit.
So she was basically like...
She was just baiting
you. She was baiting you to take the piss out of you. Oh, I got the fairy, I forgot. Yeah, okay, I'm not dead. It's great.
But yeah, so it was just really annoying. It's just one of those things where it's just
that
like...
That sounds ridiculous.
Because it's fine. Like, I get it, you know what I mean? Like, no one's going to understand me. And fucking... I may as well
I know.
But, you know, in a working environment where you got to be all professional, I'm like, I've got fucking really long hair. Like,
basically,
you know, like, tattoos. Like, I'm not... You know what I mean? I don't look very professional. But it's fine. Because
basically, what you're saying is, like... No, because, dude, like, these people are sheep, man. These people are fucking, like...
I know.
I'm sorry, if you work in an office and stuff, yeah, fair play to you. Yeah, everyone's got to do it. But if you're happy with it and you don't ever question it and you think people who are different are wrong, then you're a fucking sheep and you're a dick
it.
So I wouldn't ever feel bad about that, dude.
She wasn't feel being bad a cunt. About. I don't think anyone, when they were, like, you know... Yeah, thankfully, I
no, I think they are being a cunt. I don't think that lack of intelligence is an excuse for taking the piss out of
someone. No, she wasn't taking... The thing is... She wasn't taking the piss, but it was like, I feel like you don't need to ask these questions. You're asking to, like, confirm some kind of...
She thought you were a dick, or she thought you were a geek.
Or I thought I was a geek, or whatever.
Yeah,
exactly. And that's the problem. It's like,
that's bullshit.
I could have gone, you know what, right? In her square, in her shield, she had the following things. Wine, cats, and Didsbury. That was it.
No,
and
she didn't.
I was
didn't.
Like, wow.
Didsbury?
No, it's in the where she's from.
I know, but, oh yeah, because
I just moved in with my boyfriend, bought a house. I really like Rihanna. Cool, mate. Just shut up.
Yeah, really. Exactly. Like, I'm not about to fucking say, oh, do you wear Ugg boots?
Yeah.
Oh.
That's literally, well, I was literally exactly what I was about to say. I was just like, I wouldn't have just gone, well, so how do you find eating at restaurants on Fridays? How do you like Prosecco?
More social commentary next time on fucking Zelda.
Oh, life gets hard sometimes, but it's okay. Maybe it's not. Oh, God.
Hello.